Hello Bulleteers, in this video you will learn how to repair your bullet's right hand side switch module, which usually get carbonized or get sludged due to rainwater or aging. So this is my bullet 350 standard model from 2015. Let's start now. Firstly, remove the tying belt which holds the switch cable in position. Now from the bottom view you can see the screws. You have to open it by rotating it in anti-clockwise direction. Once you are done with this, you can see this screw also. You have to open this also in the same manner. Once you have opened both of the screws, you can open the switch module in two halves like this. Now from the top view, you can separate the switch module from the handle. In this module you can see these many black screws. Firstly you have to open this screw like this. Now you have to open the other screw, this one. I hope I'm able to focus on the screw. Once you have opened both of the screws, remove this clamp kind of thing which helps to hold the switch module in handle like this. Once you had separated this clamp, pull this indicator switch assembly above and push the on switch button inside the switch module casing. Once you are done with this, from here you can pull the horn switch above. Now you can have a closer look of the switch assembly, horn switch assembly. You can see that the points of contact of the switches have been corroded, due to which horn were not working. You can see the above point had also been corroded. So when I am pressing this switch like this, the horn is not blowing, nothing is happening. At the same time, when I short the wires, the horn is blowing, you can hear the sound. So to rectify this, you need a hammering paper. Firstly, try to troubleshoot it without opening the switch. So press the switch and pull the emery paper. You can hear some of the beeps, that means the points are getting clean. Keep doing it until you get continuous noise. So if the switch is still not working good, you can open the switch in two parts, that is by using a thin screwdriver or something like that, and push the rivet to separate the switch in two parts and open the button of the switch. Now you can pull out the rivet using a plas like this, and the button and points will separate from the switch like this. You will also get a spring in it like this. Keep them safely, as the child parts of this modules are not available in the open market. Now we have to clean this points and the springs. Firstly the point, take the emery paper and rub it over it until start shining like copper. There will be some dirt like sludge or carbon formed over the points, as the direct current is flown through these points and they act like a joint. So clean it properly. Once you are done with this point, take the spring in one hand and rub it over the amaranth pepper like this. Once you are done with the spring, take out the point from it using a plus like this, pull it out and again hold it in the plus and rub it over the amaranth pepper. It should also start shining, but rub it gently, don't just grind it like this. And I hope I am able to focus. Now hold it in a plus and put it back in the spring like the way it was. It will look something like this. After that, it's time to assemble the switchback. Firstly, put the button in one hand and put the spring and the point in this direction. Use a thin screwdriver or something and push it back on the hole so that it holds the point. Then again, put the switch into its hole and align it according to the holes. Once you have aligned the holes, put the rivet back into the hole like this and gently hammer it until it take its position. Then slowly push the rivet inside the hole like this. Not too much force is required. It will easily slide back to its position like this. Now we can check the hole. Yeah, it's working. Now some more time to be sure. Now put the switch back to its position. Make sure that this hole of the switch should align with the hole in the switch casing so that the screw can be fixed over it. Once you are done with the horn switch, you can put back the indicator switch back to its position. Now remember that this portion of the horn switch should rest over this portion of the indicator switch, else once you push the horn switch it will not come back. It should be very easy to press it like this. It should not have any resistance while pressing it. Now it's time to put back the screws on their respective holes like this. Just don't over tighten the screws, it should be just gently tightened. Now the other hole, in this hole the long screw should be gone. Once you tighten both of the screws, now check whether the switch is working or not. Yes, it is working. Now put back the plastic clamp here like this. So now it's time to put back the complete switch assembly on the handle. So for this, align the bottom part of the switch module into this clamp like this and make sure that this nail kind of thing should go into this hole on the handlebar. like this. So we are almost complete now. Now it's time to put back the screws into their respective places. So by doing this, you have saved almost around 600 to 700 bucks from your pocket, because showroom guys usually change it and do not repair it. So let's put back the screw also. Do not over tight the screws as they easily get slipped. Now this is the final thing. Put back the tie knot which holds the cable and you're ready to go. Let's check it. Thanks for watching. Kindly subscribe if you like the video.